everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play series for Solasta, Crown of the Magister. I am S.A.N, and we last left off, we did some side quests in Carolem Outpost. More specifically, we did Honor Your Masters, which it allowed Nonoshi to assist his former teacher in acquiring some rare books within Carolem. That should help him get his council seat, the seat on the council of his guild he's looking for, basically getting tenure. And we did another one, which was we have in the process at the moment, called the Sorak Relic, which was highly misleading! Highly misleading! And very difficult to find. But we eventually did manage it. And we're going to head back and get a reward for that. The other thing we'll be doing after that, the thing we'll be doing today, is we will be finally be heading towards this possible gem location. Way over there. But I want to head back to Kerr Kiflin first. So we're going to do that first. Well, let's ambush some bandits, by the looks of it. Veterans. Badlands Hunter Acolyte. Oh, this sounds like more like an other adventuring party. Alright, yeah, so Owie lost her spirit wolf the last time we fought, so she can't summon that again yet. Alright. Get to high ground. Cast spike growth. Alright. Oh, there's some over here. Yeah, those are the veterans. So those are basically high level fighters. So let's keep them out of the fight for the moment. And you go to old Chilele. Get the high ground. Right, hunter and an acolyte. Right, let's see if we can hold person on the... Alright, the hunter is now paralyzed. See if we can get over there and beat on the hunter. He seems to have a bow. Alright. And give him a spiritual weapon to fight. He's very easily going around. Alright, let's try out the annoying bee cantrip. Alright, so yeah. cost him like half his hit points. Sorry. We're going to take advantage of the fact you're paralyzed.
Die!
I already used his action surge today. See, the problem is we're coming off of another encounter. Every attack against a paralyzed target's an automatic crit. And we can heal herself because she's taking a bit of a beating today. No longer paralyzed. Alright, let's try sleep. And that had no effect. Yeah, we need some light here. Nah, not too worried about it. Attacks of opportunity against Julius. He's got very high armor class. Attacks?
I am unbeatable.
How many hit points does this guy have? This seems a bit much for a fourth level party to deal with. I haven't even taken out one yet.
Ah.
Yeah, Julius is much more suited to this than I am. Good. Cantrips.
Arcana, Evo, Malmus.
All right, let's move the spiritual weapon over here. Another one down.
We bring light in darkness.
Literally, in your case. That is literally your entire class. Okay, the Acolyte barely has any hit points yet. Acolytes are low-level clerics, basically. Yeah, I'm trying. Well, I didn't say this game was going to get harder. Considering our last random encounter we had was a joke. Yep, chase him in bear form. Second attack. It sounded like he fainted more than he died. If I'm being perfectly honest there. I rolled like a lot of fives on that. I guess it's the most common number in a D8. Cast another Cure Wounds on Julius. Almost through this fight. Almost through this completely and absolutely meaningless random encounter, which was proving harder than some of the other fights we've had in the game. Alright, the bear form is useful. That's a miss. I could tell even before. I was like, that's the wrong trajectory right there. Whew. That was, scroll protection on an evil. That was not an easy fight. Alright. All right, see what reward we got for all this trouble. Turn to a quest board. Received experience. Stardust. All right, that's arrows. Yeah. Okay, we got a reward. I'm not entirely sure what it was. I think that vial of stardust was on there. So this is just go back to Carolim again. That's the tower we did with the Honor Your Master's quest. I think I'd rather move on with the main quest for the time being. But first, let's sell some of the stuff we have and pick up some new supplies before we head out. We'll look into that Ancient Knowledge quest later. Alright, we can't use these, so... Now we can use the scrolls. I have to remember this potion is of hill giant strength. clears that up a little bit. Alright, can we craft anything more? Or I'm just basic healing potions. Yeah, we have the staff, the mace, and the wand all ready for enchanting, but we can't really do that at the moment. How are we doing for potions? Alright, I think I'm gonna give one of the greater healing potions to Julius because he's fighting a lot. We should probably pick up some more potions. And or craft some more. How much money do I have? Might as well take all of them. Yeah, some of that's the stuff we sold. Buy all those. And once again, give Julius a bit extra because he is our frontline fighter. Alright. Stocked up on healing potions. We have plenty of food. Let's head back out. We have plenty of materials to craft more potions if we need them to. And it's time for our longest journey yet. 11 days. So start traveling. Apparently one of those days is just gonna be camping on the outskirts of Kaer Kiflin. Roaming fanatics. Okay, another ambush. Okay, there's the fanatic. Where's the other? Where are the acolytes? They're over there. Okay, we're surrounded. Julius, you need to charge the fanatic. Summon the wolf. You can go assist Julius. And Shillelagh. And the wolf over here. Not quite enough to finish him off. That was a lot of damage. That was a lot more than I expected. Alright. Oh, almost done here. Let's just finish this off.
Arcana Evo Malmis.
Dead before the second and third missiles even hit. That might be worth something. We seem to run into a lot of acolytes all of a sudden. Yes, resume camping. Well, our party's back together now that we have wolf summoned again. Everyone settle in. This is gonna be a long, long journey. We might get attacked again. Whoa, we are going well off the road. Stained Hunter. What does that mean? Let's find out. That was a good hit. Alright. Let's see if we can repeat the strategy from last time. No, not this time. Well, the good news is we have two people with that spell. Paralyzed. action surge. And again. I'd find it to have him turn even though he can't move.
Death reaches out for you.
Alright, well, I'm not gonna get close, but let's take advantage of this. Yeah, but range attacks aren't auto crits. He's paralyzed, he can't really surrender. Ah, that was child's play this time. Yeah, hold person's a pretty powerful spell, especially when properly utilized. Did he drop anything? No. Alright. Day 5 of 11. We're still going really far out of the way, considering we're following a hunch. Another one. Oh, we're surprised this time. Oh, this should be good. Oh good, dire wolves. This is already off to a bad start. Yeah, get the high ground. Yeah, that's too far for old person. That's unfortunate, that would come in really handy again. Try scorching red. Yeah. Ooh, one was a crit. Ow. Alright, second level Thunder Wave. Step out of harm's way. Cannot see the target. Oh, well, this is just, high ground is not working for me here. That was an awful lot of effort to go through just to be able to see this guy. It works. Oh, that worked. Oh, quite well. Yeah, jump there. See if this gets you within range. For hold person. Yeah, he's no longer paralyzed. I was afraid of that. Alright, let's just go for Magic Whistle on this direwolf so we can push it off. Not quite, but almost there. Good. Once more. Just saved this time. Black bear time. Guiding bolt really, really works out well for us. Have you noticed that? Yeah. You can't take much more of this. My turn for a whole person. A lot of these, like, poachers, I guess, is what they are. Resume camping. I think we're only gonna get to where we're going before the end of the video. By the end of the video. Day 9. At least don't have to worry about food. We're taking the most circuitous route to get to this possible gem location. Alright, this should be our final long rest before we reach there. Minor air element. Alright. This will be a first. We haven't fought elementals yet. Right beside him. Yep, alright. This looks like about the right amount of health for an air elemental from Dungeons & Dragons. We fought them in the game. They have about 90 hit points. Bear's been very handy thus far. Alright, let's go over here. And this looks like it's going to be a long fight, so mage armor. Alright, that's the end of the surprise round. Let's help them out with the guiding bolt. Missed! This is looking quite a bit like an arrow, just a Standard air elemental. Resist piercing. Okay. There we go, that did a fair bit of damage. They're not resistant to force. Alright, let's bring the hammer over. Yes, because I can disengage and head back down. Okay, she's unconscious. I can't remember if we've had that happen in this campaign or this game yet. I think that might be the first time. Magic weapon. He doesn't have to worry about resistance as to damage, his weapon damage. Alright. Okay, she succeeded at that saving throw. Oh, yeah, we need to take care of this thing.
Truly formidable.
Good. One success, one failure. engage a move. Let's let the wolf take over. She rolled a natural 20. She's up and she gets her turn. That is the best case scenario in these situations. Took on an air elemental and won. Oh, we're gonna level up too. Excellent. That's a nice thing about all those encounters we've been having. Yes, there's more long rest. Good. We'll be fifth level before we have to go into this dungeon. Yep, time to level up. Level 5. Very important level for wizards. Alright. I actually have a scroll of counter spell, so I can just add it to my spellbook that way. I really, really, really liked Fly. That was a lot of fun. And Tongues is good too. Alright, let's start with Fly, and because we're going to need some firepower going forward, let's take the classic Fireball. Alright, Sleep is probably going to start being less useful at this point, and I'm going to prepare Fly and Featherfall. Scroll of Daylight, so that should be fine for the moment. Alright, there we go. Yeah, we now get to turn undead, now I can become destroy undead. Alright, so she always. Zaya always has Daylight prepared, that's good. Hypnotic Pattern is the other one. That's less good. Alright, Mass Healing Word is very important. We have a few ways of doing Revivify at the moment, so I'm not too concerned. And Spirit Guardians, that's the other big cleric spell. That's Drop Shield of Faith, it's not really coming in handy. Beacon of Hope. Might be good too. Range of wisdom saving throws and death saving throws, healing restores. Yeah, let's get that. Drop bless. Alright, Julius! He gets his extra attack at this level, which is nice. But very little else. Guys? No, did the game crash or something? Oh. I have to hit resume. Okay, that's the first time I've leveled up while traveling, so I didn't know how to do that. I was a little worried there for a moment. All we've ended up in a spooky part of the world. Yeah, I want to copy that spell in my spellbook. I'm going to save first. This music reminds me of a lot of gothic horror. Also reminds you specifically of the Necropolis theme from Heroes 3. Alright. Good, we have Counterspell now. Very, very, very useful spell. I don't have it prepared at the moment, but I'll prepare it on the next long rest. Alright. The Dark Castle. Okay, it's being manned by skeletons. That is probably not the best thing of a sign. Oh, and there's a giant...
In the castle? Maybe. It's in that direction.
There's a giant malevolent red vortex over the castle.
Garrison of 2 dozen, please.
We're not getting in that way.
Could we climb up?
It's too open out here. We'd be easy targets.
We'll have to find another way.
We could just show our Legacy Council credentials.
Assuming they're law-abiding folk who respect the Council.
Not too many of those around here, I'm guessing.
Yeah, we're pretty far away from the Council's authority. No, we are going to need to find... We're going to need to find another way in. Alright, we're nearing the hour mark. As annoying as it is to end an episode right where we've gotten to where we're going, I think this is where we're going to have to call it. Because a lot is going to happen in this castle. And it's going to take multiple episodes to get through anyway. And I'd rather not this drag on for too long, so as annoying as it seems... We'll be stopping here for today, unfortunately. Yeah, lots of random encounters mostly today. But we got to fifth level, which is good. Now we've got access to some of our strongest spells. Julius can attack twice in a round without using an action surge, which is nice. And we have a castle full of undead to explore next time, in hopes of finding the next gem. So, until then... Thank you for watching, everyone. Please remember to like and subscribe, and please join me here again next time as we explore the Dark Castle and try and find this mysterious gem, which may or may not be at this location. I just want to point that out. We've gone to great lengths to get here on a whim. Goodbye, everyone.